students, welcome to another session at Graduate Guru. And our topic, which we are doing right now, is capital, revenue, expenditure and receipts or income. So going ahead, last time we discussed two sums where we had different items, jahan pe humne usse classify kiya tha into capital, revenue, expense, income, receipts and all. So same thing we are going to do in question number 3. So let's begin. Question 3, first item is cost of 10,000 for hiring a truck to transport goods from factory to shop. So it is nothing but transportation charges. We are paying transportation for bringing the goods from the factory to the shop. So this is obviously our normal trading activity because it is in relation to goods, right? So what if it is trading, what do we classify it as? Revenue expense. So it's going to be revenue expense. Revenue expense and amount is 10,000. What are the reasons? We said it is trading activity, so it is in respect of business. So in respect of normal business, obviously the benefit is short term, so it's a short term benefit. And it is recurring in nature. Every time hum goods transport karenge, we will have to pay it. So that is why we have called it revenue expense. Next is raw materials of rupees 50,000, wages of rupees 20,000 spent for construction of factory shed. What is a factory shed? It's a part of the factory. So, I am paying raw material and wages for factory shed. Factory shed is nothing but an asset. It's a part of your factory. Go down jaisa rehta hai. So, that's your factory shed. So, it is a part of my asset. Asset se related hai means it is investing activity. Investing activity is always capital in nature. So I am going to classify it as capital expense. Capital expense total of raw material and wages, which is 70,000. Now, even though it is raw material and wages, because it is in connection with asset, I am going to classify it as capital only. Don't get confused that it is revenue just because you are seeing raw material and wages. Okay? So, what could be the reason? In relation to construction of asset, I am constructing a new asset. So that is why, that's my first reason why I'm calling it capital. It is obviously non-recurring. Same asset again and again we will not construct. So it is non-recurring and it has a long-term benefit. So that is why we are classifying it as capital and not revenue. The next is advertisement expense of rupees 80,000 for hiring space on a hoarding which will be displayed for 2 years. So basically it is an advertisement on a hoarding. Advertisement that is going to be displayed on a hoarding. Hoarding are these big boards that we see on building, jis par alag alag companies ki ads hoti hai. Okay, so that's your hoarding. Now, even though I am paying it for 2 years, you remember the deferred revenue expense topic that we discussed in a previous session? where we had said that heavy advertisement अगर है and it is for more than a year, generally वो deferred revenue expense हो जाता है. But accounting standard 26 has told us that it is not deferred revenue. You have to treat it as revenue expense. So I'm going to classify it as revenue expense. And because it will give me benefit for 2 years, what we are going to do? एक साल का एडवर्टाइजमेंट हम पीएनएल में उसी साल बता देंगे एंड जो एक साल का बाकी रहेगा दैट विल बी शोन इन बैलेंस शीट एज प्रीपेड एक्सपेंस. प्रीपेड मींस हमने एडवांस में पे कर दिया है. सो इट विल शो एज एन एसेट टेम्पररीली इन द बैलेंस शीट. सो हाउ दैट विल बी गिवन इफेक्ट टू इन फाइनल अकाउंट्स वी विल सी दैट समटाइम लेटर इन सम अदर चैप्टर. सो फॉर नाउ because AS 26 says that it has to be revenue, I am going to treat it as revenue expense, the full amount of 80,000. Okay, this is in relation to business activities. Okay, and also as per accounting standard 26. Okay, so these are the reasons why I'm treating it as revenue expense. Next says amount of 50,000 spent on overhauling the machinery to increase its useful life. So what is my item first? Let us write that down. Overhauling of machinery. Overhauling of machine. Now what is overhauling? पूरा machine dismantle करते हैं, पूरा उसको खोल देते हैं and we rearrange it, refix it again. And यहाँ पे specifically दिया है that it is done to increase its useful life. So अगर हमने machine को ऐसे ही रहने दिया होता तो maybe I would have been able to use it only for 5 years. But because I did this overhauling, maybe uski life 2 saal se aur badh gayi. So I will be able to use my machine for a longer period. So in short, it is extending the life of my asset and that is why I am going to call it capital expense. So this is going to be a capital expense because it has increased the life of my asset. I will be able to use it longer. Amount is 50,000. Reason number one, increases life of asset. Okay, it is non-recurring. हम बार-बार ऐसे machine खोल के दुबारा fix नहीं कर सकते. So it is non-recurring. And it gives me long-term benefit because as we said, it has increased the life of my asset. So it has given me long-term benefit. If you want to add, you can also add that increase in the income because generally overhauling karke machinery starts working a little faster and better. So it is also increasing my income. Coming to our next item, fifth item, new printer purchased in exchange of old one for a net amount of ₹7,500. So basically I am exchanging old printer for new. Exchanging old printer with a new one. Now the net amount which is given to us means हमने एक printer दिया उसके बदले दूसरा printer लिया. Net पुराने का जो भी exchange value है that is not given to us. Net हमें उसको भरना पड़ा 7,500. But in short what have we done? We have bought a new asset. Printer एक asset है. So we have bought a new asset. Asset purchase किया है. It is going to be capital expense. So this is a capital expense of 7,500. Okay. And what are the reasons? It is purchase of asset. So that is my first reason, purchase of asset, which we also term as investing activity. Obviously, it is long-term benefit because a new asset will run for many years, not just 1 year. So long-term benefit, non-recurring in nature, because again and again, I'm not going to purchase new printers. So the one which we've purchased will give us use for many years. Next is advertisement expense of 500 for placing an ad in the local newspaper. Okay. So now this is a advertisement in local newspaper. Why do we place an ad in the paper? To promote our business. Why do we want to promote our business? So that our sales increase. Sales will increase, our profit will increase. So what are we trying to do? This is just to, we are trying to earn more income. So that is revenue in nature. So this is going to be a revenue expense of 500. Reason, promoting business, to earn more income. Okay, and the benefit is going to be short term. Again, after few days, we will have to give an advertisement in the paper. So it is going to be recurring also. So those two are other reasons. Short-term benefit and recurring in nature. Okay, so that is why it is revenue expense. Next is cost of research and development of a new product successfully launched in the market, 1,50,000. So, research and development cost, 1,50,000. The research for? To bring a new product in the market. What is research? Naya product banane ka jo bhi process hai, we do trial and error. Kabhi first time it might not be successful. You'll again have to try something else. Thoda uska chemical combination change karna padega. The way you're manufacturing it change karna padega. So all that is a part of your research and development. So usme jo bhi expense hota hai, before AS 26, hum usse deferred revenue karte the. But AS 26 says that it has to be a revenue expense. P&L mein pura dikha ke usko write off kar dena hai. So, because of the AS 26, we are going to call it revenue expense. Amount being 1,50,000. So, even though the amount is big, that is not going to change our classification. It will remain revenue. First reason being, as per accounting standard, 26. And next is, this is normal business. Kyunki hum naya product develop kar rahe hain jo hume bechna hai. So this is my normal business activity. So that is also one of the reasons why we are taking it to revenue. So it's my normal business activity. Okay. Next says, 70,000 paid for purchase of goodwill of another business. So what am I purchasing? I'm purchasing goodwill. What is goodwill? Goodwill is the reputation of a business. Jab hum kisi business ka naam apne business ke saath jod lete hain, so if that business is famous, uska fame हमें पास ऑन होगा. सो आर बिजनेस विल इंक्रीज, हम ज्यादा कमा सकेंगे बिकॉज हमारा नाम उनके साथ जुड़ा हुआ है. सो दैट नेम, दैट रेप्यूटेशन, दैट फेम इज नथिंग बट गुडविल. इन अकाउंट्स गुडविल इज एन एसेट, इट इज एन इनटेंजिबल एसेट. व्हाट इज इनटेंजिबल? वन विच आई कैन नॉट सी, फील और टच, बट स्टिल इट इज एन एसेट विच विल गिव मी बेनिफिट फॉर लॉन्ग टर्म. सो इन शॉर्ट व्हाट एम आई डूइंग, आई एम परचेजिंग गुडविल, आई एम परचेजिंग एसेट. एसेट हो गया मीन्स इट इज इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी. इन्वेस्टिंग इज ऑलवेज कैपिटल इन नेचर, सो इट इज कैपिटल एक्सपेंस. The full amount that I am paying for goodwill, which is 70,000. Why? Because it is purchase of intangible asset. Okay, gives me long term benefit. It also increases our earning capacity. किसी और का goodwill खरीद के उनका नाम अपने साथ जोड़ के I will be able to earn more. So increase in earning capacity. Okay, and that is why it is capital. Next says rent received of rupees 24,000 for subletting of office premises. So rent received from subletting premises. What is subletting? किसी और की ऑफिस को हमने रेंट पे लिया हुआ है, वी आर ऑलरेडी पेइंग टू दैट पर्सन, एंड नाउ आई हैव सम एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस इन दैट ऑफिस, आई एम गिविंग इट टू समबडी एल्स एंड ही इज गिविंग मी रेंट. ओके, सो इन शॉर्ट किसी और का एसेट जो मैं ऑलरेडी रेंट पे ले रही हूं, दैट आई एम फर्दर गिविंग ऑन रेंट टू समबडी एल्स, दैट इज कॉल्ड सब लेटिंग. ओके, this is not my asset and I am not giving the whole asset. I am giving the asset getting rent from time to time from that person. So this is nothing but revenue income or revenue receipt. Okay, why is it revenue? It is recurring in nature because every month we will get rent, so it is recurring. Benefit is short term, only for that particular period for which you receive rent. So short term benefit. Okay, and that is why it is revenue in nature. The last item of this sum, sale of old machinery for rupees 15,000. और ब्रैकेट में हमें उसका बुक वैल्यू दिया है 12,500. सो लेट्स फर्स्ट राइट डाउन सेल ऑफ ओल्ड मशीनरी. ओके, दिस इज एन एसेट, पुराना हो गया, मैंने उसे बेच दिया. मेरे बुक्स में उसका वैल्यू कितना है? बुक वैल्यू मींस इन माय बैलेंस शीट व्हाट एम आई शोइंग इट एट? 12,500. हमने बेचा कितने में? 15,000. सो आई हैव गॉट मोर देन द बुक वैल्यू. मेरा सेलिंग प्राइस मेरी वैल्यू से ज्यादा है बाय 2,500. सो व्हेन आई एम सेलिंग द एसेट, द अमाउंट व्हिच आई एम गेटिंग इज कैपिटल रिसीट. सो द फर्स्ट थिंग इज कैपिटल रिसीट of 15,000. ये हम एसेट से माइनस कर देंगे बिकॉज इतना एसेट बाहर गया है. मीन्स नॉट द फुल अमाउंट बट द बुक वैल्यू अमाउंट. ओके, सो इट्स अ कैपिटल रिसीट. और
we are getting a capital gain, gain or profit,
क्योंकि हमने उसे ज्यादा में बेचा है. 2500 is my gain
and that is also
capital in nature. Why are both these things capital in nature? Because it is in relation to asset.
So, in relation to asset,
okay, it also increases the funds of our business.
हमें पैसे मिल रहे हैं with which I can do some other investing activity.
So, it increases the funds.
It is non-recurring. It is not my business to sell machine.
Machine एक asset है जो हम कभी कभार बेचेंगे. So, it is non-recurring. So, that is why I have treated it as capital receipt और उसका जो profit भी होगा, that is also capital in nature. So, this is it for the question number 3. Take it down and then we go ahead. Moving on to question number 4. Question number 4, first item says, legal expenses of 30,000 incurred for defending a suit for breach of contract in respect of goods. Means, हमारा किसी के साथ contract था to sell the goods and we could not fulfill that contract. हमने वो contract complete नहीं किया. तो उसने हम पर case कर दिया है. And we are defending that case. हमें obviously एक lawyer appoint करना पड़ेगा. So we are paying legal charges for that. So let's write down what it is first. Legal expense for defending suit. Suit is the case. Okay. Now this is in relation to goods. It is for breach of contract in respect of goods. Goods se related kabhi bhi kuch bhi expense karte hain hum, it will be revenue expense. So this is going to be my revenue expense. The amount is 30,000. What are the reasons? First, in relation to goods. Okay? It gives us short-term benefit. Wo ek particular case file karne mein hume help milegi. So, it's a short-term benefit. Okay? And it might not be recurring. So, every time a revenue expense might not be recurring. Har baar hume case, hum par case nahi kiya jayega. Har baar hum legal charges nahi pay karenge. So, it's not recurring in nature. But that does not make it capital expense. Why? Because it is in relation to goods. Next says, discount on issue of shares 10,000. So, discount on issue of shares. Shares are a part of the capital of the company. Hum shares issue karte hain aur agar hum shareholders se kam paise lete hain, 100 rupees ke share ke badle hum unse sirf 95 rupees lete hain, to jo baki ka jo difference hai 5 rupees ka, that becomes my discount. Okay, now this type of an expense is specifically treated as deferred revenue expense. हमने already explain पहले किया हुआ है, व्हाट इज डिफर्ड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस, उसके एग्जांपल्स में भी हमने ये एग्जांपल देखा था दैट डिस्काउंट ऑन शेयर्स और डिबेंचर्स इज डिफर्ड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस. सो लेट्स राइट दैट डिफर्ड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस. Amount is 10,000. Why is it deferred revenue? First of all, it is non-recurring. Okay? This is a non-recurring expense. Hum shares bar bar issue nahi karte. Shares are issued once in 5 to 10 years. The company does not issue shares every year. So, it is non-recurring. It is in relation to financing activity. Isme trading kuch nahi hai. Because it is shares. Shares are the capital of the company. Hum capital raise kar rahe hai. Uske relation mein hume expense ho raha hai. So, it is in relation to financing activity. Okay? And this discount which we have borne, it is giving me a long-term benefit. लंबे समय तक मुझे ये shares के पैसों का use मिल रहा है. So it is giving me a long-term benefit. Okay? And that is why it is deferred revenue in nature. It could be capital also. But a discount can never be capital. Discount by nature is revenue. Okay? So, even though it is revenue related to financing, that is why we are calling it deferred revenue. Hum na hi use revenue bol rahe hain, na hi hum use capital bol rahe hain. Okay? So, that was a different item in this sum. Next is premium of 10,000 received on issue of debentures. Isme discount tha on shares. Now, we are getting premium. So, let's write that premium on issue of is bar debentures hai. Now, this is the opposite. वहां पर हमें 100 rupees के share के बदले we took 95, 5 rupees was discount. Now, I am issuing it at a premium. So, suppose there is a debenture of 10 rupees. I am giving it to the public at 12 rupees. So, 2 rupees is my premium. Now, what will this be? This will not be deferred revenue. This will be capital receipt. It will be a capital receipt. The full amount that they have said, 10,000. Why? First of all, it is in relation to financing. It is financing activity. This money will be in my business for long term. So, it's long term in nature. It is obviously non-recurring. It is not going to happen again and again. Shares or debentures are not issued from time to time. It takes a long time gap before we issue shares or debentures. So, non-recurring. Okay. So, financing activity hai. Anything related to financing will always go as capital. So, this I am going to show in my balance sheet. I am not going to take it in my profit and loss. Next is 20,000 spent on registering a patent on our product. Let me first write down and then I'll explain what a patent is. So, registering patent. Patent kya hota hai? It is like a copyright. Means, maine jo cheez banai hai, us par sirf mera hi right hai, hak hai. Nobody else can copy that same product. So, that's a patent. So, whenever a company manufactures some particular product, jo dusre product se alag hai, wo apna ek patent register kar dete hain. Now, patent for accounts is nothing but an asset. जैसे हमने लास्ट सम में गुडविल देखा, intangible asset, वैसे ही patent भी intangible asset ही है. So, I am going to take it as a capital expense.
So, this is also going to be capital expense
of 20,000.
Why? Because it is purchase of intangible asset. Which will last me for long term. So, long term benefit. And the expense is non-recurring in nature.
Okay. So, that is our patent. Next says, purchase of uniforms and shoes for staff worth rupees 52,000. So, let's write that. Purchase of uniforms and shoes. Now, this uniforms and shoes is to maintain our staff. Staff se related expense hai. So, it's a normal business expense. Jo bhi hum kharcha humare staff ke liye karte hai, wo hum kharcha kar dete hai aur fir uska benefit staff ko milta hai. But why am I doing that expense? Taki wo staff humare liye kaam karte rahe. Company chhodkar chale nahi jaye. So, this is for my normal business activity so that I can run my business smoothly. So, it is a revenue expense.
Revenue expense of 52,000.
And what are the reasons?
Normal business activities.
It helps in the smooth conduct of business.
And that is why I have called it revenue expense.
Next is import duty paid on purchase of computer with software 1,25,000.
So, import duty on computers.
We must have imported the computers from abroad. उसके लिए हमने जब हम computers ला रहे हैं इंडिया में, we have paid some import duty. It is in connection with purchase of asset. अगर मैं import duty नहीं pay करती हूँ, can I bring the asset to my working place? No. So, asset को लाने के लिए ये खर्चा जरूरी है and that is why it is capital in nature.
So, it's a capital expense of 1,25,000.
Okay. Why?
In relation to purchase of asset, computers are our assets which we are purchasing.
उससे related कोई भी खर्चा होगा, we will take it as capital.
So, in relation to purchase of asset, long term benefit, obviously the asset will be used for a long term and also it is non-recurring. I don't have to pay it again and again.
एक बार हमने import किया, तभी हमने import duty pay की. Okay? So, that is capital expense. Next is, repair cost of old machine 10,000 to keep it in working condition.
So, what is the item? It says repair cost of machine. And they have specified that it is to keep it in working condition. Uski nahi life extend kar rahe hai,
ना ही उसकी अर्निंग कैपेसिटी एक्सटेंड कर रहे हैं। ये नॉर्मल रिपेयर है, बिगड़ गई है मशीन, उसे वापस चलाने के लिए वी आर स्पेंडिंग द रिपेयर कॉस्ट। सो दिस इज फॉर आर नॉर्मल फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द एसेट एंड इट विल बी रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस।
This is normal repair expense and that is why it is revenue.
एक earlier sum में हमने देखा था जहां पर उसकी life extend की थी, उसका repair किया था, that would have gone to capital. So this amount is 10,000.
The reason is to keep asset functional.
So to maintain my business activities,
ताकि हमारी business activities पर कोई असर ना पड़े and I am able to conduct my business normally. So maintain business activities,
okay? And it's recurring. Repairs हम बार बार करवाते हैं,
so I can also say that it's a recurring expenditure.
ऐसा repairs बहुत बार होता है during the life of the मशीन। नेक्स्ट इज प्रोफेशनल लीगल एंड कंसल्टेंसी चार्जेस ऑफ 25,000 पेड इन कनेक्शन विद परचेज ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी।
सो वी आर पेइंग सम प्रोफेशनल एंड लीगल चार्जेस फॉर परचेजिंग प्रॉपर्टी। Now this is in connection with asset.
जब हम प्रॉपर्टी परचेज करते हैं, हमें डॉक्यूमेंट्स बनाने होते हैं, रजिस्ट्रेशन फीस लगती है, इस सारी चीजों के लिए वी अपॉइंट एक्सपर्ट्स, उन एक्सपर्ट्स के हम चार्जेस पे कर रहे हैं, बट इट इज इन रिलेशन टू प्रॉपर्टी विच इज एन एसेट, सो इट विल बी कैपिटल एक्सपेंस।
व्हाटएवर अमाउंट यू हैव पेड, that is 25,000,
fully capital. Why?
In relation to purchase of asset. Obviously, it is non-recurring and it also gives us long-term benefit.
That is why we are treating it as capital. Next is life membership fees of 8,000 received from a member of the club.
So this is a receipt and it is life membership fees received. Now when I receive life membership fees,
it is a one-time receipt. बार बार हमें मेंबर ये पैसा नहीं देंगे। दिस इज व्हेन दे आर जॉइनिंग द क्लब, दे पे इट वंस एंड दैट कीप्स देम अ मेंबर फॉर लाइफ टाइम। सो दिस इज ऑब्वियसली कैपिटल इन नेचर। व्हाई? बिकॉज इट्स अ वन टाइम थिंग। सो कैपिटल रिसीट ओके, अमाउंट इज 8,000।
Why? Long term, first of all. Long term, one time payment hai ye. So it's a one time payment which makes it non-recurring.
So we are not going to get this money again and again. And why do we take membership fees from members of the club? It is like financing. Club mein share capital nahi hota hai. उसके बदले हम मेंबर्स से मेंबरशिप फीस लेते हैं। सो दिस इज नथिंग बट फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी।
सो दैट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ आवर रीजंस व्हाई इट इज कैपिटल इन नेचर। सो इट इज
फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी। द नेक्स्ट वन, द लास्ट वन ऑफ दिस सम, वॉलंटरी रिटायरमेंट कॉम्पेंसेशन पेड टू एन एम्प्लॉय 4 लाख।
Voluntary retirement compensation. Now, this amount is paid
when an employee leaves the company by himself. Means, बहुत साल की सर्विस के बाद अगर एक एम्प्लॉई को कंपनी छोड़नी है, so generally he is given a good package and उसमें हम उसे voluntary retirement scheme देते हैं, जहाँ पर वो खुद रिटायर हो रहा है, कंपनी उसे रिटायर नहीं कर रही है, and for that you pay a compensation. Now this, even though it is a one-time payment to the employee को एक ही बार ये मिलेगा, but company ऐसे हर employee को देती है, so for the company it is kind of a recurring expense. प्लस इस एक्सपेंस से हमें कोई लॉन्ग टर्म बेनिफिट नहीं मिल रही है. द बेनिफिट इज ऑल टू द एम्प्लॉई. व्हाई वी आर पेइंग हिम द कॉम्पेंसेशन? बिकॉज ही हैज वर्क्ड वेल फॉर आवर कंपनी फॉर मेनी इयर्स. सो इवन दो इट मे लुक लाइक अ कैपिटल एक्सपेंस बिकॉज इट इज वन टाइम, बिकॉज द अमाउंट इज बिग, स्टिल यू आर गोइंग टू ट्रीट इट एज रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस.
So it's a revenue expense of 4 lakhs.
Why? Because it's for
normal business activity.
And it does not create any long-term asset.
So does not create asset.
So it cannot be an investing activity, and that is why I am treating it as revenue. So this is it for question 4. This ends our chapter. I'll give you some small homework of around 5 to 6 items which you can solve on the own, but before that we'll discuss it, and before that you take down this sum. So now going to our homework sum, there are some 5 items which we will discuss. I'll just give you a hint and you can solve it by yourself. The first one says purchase of furniture and computers for office 1,50,000. Obviously this is a direct purchase of assets, furniture, computers, ye sare assets hote hain. If we are purchasing assets, it is going to be capital expense. Next is issue of shares of 5 lakhs at a discount of rupees 10,000. So, यहाँ पर दो items है. One is issue of shares. जब हम shares issue करते हैं, हमें पैसा मिल रहा है, which is financing. हमारे business में पैसा आ रहा है. So, जो 5 lakh है, that is a capital receipt and it will go to balance sheet. So, you will call it capital receipt. और जो 10,000 का discount है, वो हमने ऑलरेडी देखा है दैट इट इज डिफर्ड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस. ओके, एनी डिस्काउंट ऑन इश्यू ऑफ शेयर्स और डिबेंचर्स इज ट्रीटेड एज डिफर्ड रेवेन्यू. नेक्स्ट इज टेलीफोन चार्जेस पेड फॉर द मंथ 2,200. दिस इज योर नॉर्मल बिजनेस एक्सपेंस. इट हेल्प्स अस टू रन द बिजनेस स्मूथली, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस. 18,000 रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम सेल ऑफ गुड्स which were purchased for 15,000. हमने कुछ goods खरीदे हैं 15,000 के. Goods हैं. What are goods? They are the things in which the business deals. तो हम goods क्यों खरीदते हैं? बेचने के लिए, ताकि हमें profit हो. So जो goods खरीदने का cost है 15,000, that will be your revenue expense. और जब हम उसे बेचते हैं, हमें जो पैसे मिलते हैं 18,000, that will be our revenue receipt. And you can also calculate your revenue profit from that, revenue gain or revenue profit, which will be 18,000 minus 15,000, 3,000. And the last one is legal fees paid to lawyer for defending an income tax case. So, income tax is something that you pay every year to the government. Har saal hum income tax bharte hai, sometimes there is a problem or a dispute. हमें जितना टैक्स हमें लगता है कि हमें जितना टैक्स भरना है गवर्नमेंट को उतना नहीं लगता दे फील दैट आई नीड टू पे मोर सो उसमें देयर इज अ डिस्प्यूट व्हिच गिव्स राइज टू अ केस और अ सूट एंड फॉर दैट आई नीड अ लॉयर फॉर व्हिच आई हैव पेड हिम फीस एंड दैट विल बी रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस बिकॉज दिस इज योर नॉर्मल बिजनेस एक्टिविटी पेइंग इनकम टैक्स डज नॉट क्रिएट एनी एसेट लीगल फीस मैं जो ये पे कर रही हूँ उससे भी कोई एसेट क्रिएट नहीं होगा इट विल ओनली हेल्प टू सेव माई बिजनेस सो इट हेल्प्स द बिजनेस टू रन स्मूथली एंड दैट इज वाई इट इज रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंस होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस टॉपिक ओके एंड दिस टॉपिक द एंट्रीज दैट वी हैव डन दिस डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन रेवेन्यू एंड कैपिटल दैट वी हैव डन थ्रू आउट इन दीज सेशंस will help us to make our final accounts properly. So, the next topic we'll be going on to is final accounts, which will be related to this topic and this topic helps us to understand and do that topic well. Thank you.